custody war basically broke out over the possession of Henry's brain. In some ways, he was this sort of scientific golden goose, right? He was a man who you know, could you know, if you had privileged access to patient HM, that was something that could kind of, you know, make your career. And a lot of people did sort of, you know, build their careers on access to him. And so you have this sort of difficult conflict of interest. When a research scientist has this sort of valuable access to and valuable connection to a profoundly damaged individual, it becomes in that scientist's best interest to sort of maintain that level of access and maintain that level of control and maintain that level of sort of ownership over that damaged individual. And I think that problems related to sort of feelings of ownership and these sort of proprietary feelings that built up over the years play themselves out in sometimes disturbing ways in the case of patient HM.
Well, and you raised specifically the case of Dr. Suzanne Corkin, who was the MIT researcher who had the longest period with patient HM, right?
Correct. Suzanne Corkin was the so-called principal investigator in his case for many decades. She worked with him longer than anyone. She also, I do have this odd family connection to her. She was my mom's oldest friend. They grew up across the street from one another, you know, talking on tin can telephones as little girls, and then she went on to inherit my grandfather's most famous patient. Suzanne Corkin definitely, over the years, I think, developed these sort of proprietary feelings towards patient HM. And in some cases, you know, I found evidence that sort of, you know, sense of, I don't know, possession and that sort of desire for control led her to take some actions that are troubling.
Control of the narrative, right? Of the story,
yeah.
Of
control of, I mean, control in a very real sense of Henry. The people who have been writing about Henry have had an interest in telling his story in a very particular way. Henry himself was, you know, neurologically unable to tell his own story. I mean, the deficits, the lesions in his brain made that really impossible for him. One of the things that I hope my book accomplishes is in a certain way, you know, sort of liberating his story from the people who have, you know, so far had an interest in telling it in a particular way, from the research scientists, including Suzanne Corkin, who built their careers on Henry's back.
And one more thing about with that, because it's a fairly serious ethical charges that you raise with Dr. Corkin. She died earlier this year.
She did.
She had written her own book about patient HM. Did she have any chance to address what you raised?
It's very sad that she passed away, and I wish she'd had a chance to directly address them.
All right, the book is Patient HM, A Story of Memory, Madness, and Family Secrets. Luke Dittrich, thank you so much.
Thank you.